Plum here, and welcome agents to this week's Secret Vendor Reset, the greatest on the interweb. Cassie's current location is right here in Foggy Bottom, and she'll be here for the next 23 hours or so, and after that she'll be closed for 32 hours, and then reopen somewhere else. On each rotation, you can grab her location from the snitch. If you can't find him, that's okay, I've got a handy little video in the description on his locations, so you should go down and check that out. So let's see what's for sale at the shop this week. Cassie's starting it off with the Emelina's Guard SMG. It's got max SMG, 14.5 crit chance and optimal range, which you could roll off if you want. The talents, perfect preservation. Killing a bad guy repairs 12% of your armor over 5 seconds. Headshot kills improve this by 12%. The Anarchist Cookbook. I mean, the rolls look okay, so definitely grab it if you don't have one. It comes with Perfectly Wicked, and I love this talent. Applying a status effect increases your total weapon damage by 18% for 27 seconds. This is the talent I use on my armor regen build, and if you haven't checked out that video after this one, pop on over and give it a look-see too. And if you've opened your ivory box in the White House, you'll have a shield splinter up. It's got the best rolls I've seen in a long time. It comes with Perfect Optimus. Damage is increased by 4% for every 10% of your ammo missing. And if you've stepped up to the plate and grinded it out and opened your white box in New York, you'll have the Hunter Killer chest. It's a tough one on this one. I'm not sure how I really feel about these rolls. The talent's Perfect Intimidate. While you have bonus armor, you amplify your weapon damage by 40% to baddies within 10 meters. I'll leave this one up to you guys. To the gear set items, this Negotiator's backpack has 11.8% weapon damage and health. I'll pass, but you might not. We've got a Tip of the Spear's chest with 11.7 weapon damage and explosive resistance, no thanks. Striker's gloves with 8% weapon damage and a near max roll of skill damage. Maybe stat bank the skill damage if you don't already have it, maybe. Hardwired knees, you can definitely stat bank this max crit damage roll if you need to, or re-roll it off to whatever you like. We've got a True Patriot holster with armor and repair skills. I'm not a fan, so I'll be passing. An ongoing directive mask with 10.8% weapon damage and status effect. This could work nicely for a DPS status hybrid build, but only in PvE. The basic gear items this week, we've got a Fal. It's not terrible, but I'm really not sure what you'd roll, and I'm sure you'd get a better one if you farmed for one. The Spaz 12 might have been okay with a different talent, but it doesn't, so pass. The Mirakami chest has Empathic Resolve, which is a great talent, but these rainbow rolls just mean Cassie will be holding onto this item for the week. These RNK knees are really poor too, so skip them. To the mods, we've got an 8.7% skill duration. I feel if you're going to run these types of mods, you really want to be running Skill Haste or Repair Skill mods only. So pass. And again, another plus one target for your Firefly. So that's Cassie for the week. Remember, Season 2 Manhunt is now live, and you've got a little over 2 weeks till the next one kicks in. Also, just a quick reminder, Kenley College is open again. Make sure you pop on over, check it out, but do take plenty of faction keys, because there's a heap of those boxes around. And with the improved loot system, this might be a nice little area to farm, especially for all the new players and returning players. Well, that wraps up this one, agents. So, did you like it? Then smash that like button. And if you didn't like it, you can press the dislike. But remember, support me and the channel, hit that sub button, and become a creepy subscriber. I'll catch you all in the next one. I'm Plum, Plum out.